Hi again, it's Jason from Fraser Valley Rose Farm, and I have really noticed a lot of inflation in my personal purchases these days. You go to the grocery store, and not only are the prices going up, but if you look real close, the package is getting smaller, so you're paying more and getting less. But this is not a new trick in consumer packaging. In fact, the fertilizer industry, their whole job is to take bulk fertilizers like this, things that are inexpensively available when bought in a big bag, and take them, blend them, cut them down, dilute them, and put them in a little tiny package so you're spending $10 on something that has a very, very small amount of fertilizer value in it. Now, thankfully, they do have to post a guaranteed analysis on the outside of those bags. So what I want to talk to you about today is how to look at that guaranteed analysis, look at the cost per liter or cost per pound, and make some smart buying decisions about your fertilizer. And one of the strategy that can work here, depending on what you have available locally, is you can go past those retail outlets and go to the source. I'm talking feed stores and horticulture stores, and buy these things either in larger bulks or in simple nutrients or simple amendments that can save you some money. Let's talk about that today. It'll be no surprise to you that the smaller the package, the more ready to use the product, the more you're going to pay for it. This is the way it is in consumer packaging. One extreme example of this that will blow your mind in terms of margin is a product by Scott's Miracle-Gro. Now, what they've done is they've actually marketed a whole hydroponic growing system called the Aerogarden. And what it has is it has its own tray of reservoir of water. It has its own light. It's kind of a fully hydroponic system. But it would not surprise me if the entire motive for this hardware is to sell the liquid fertilizer, because the markup on it is astounding. What it ends up is they're selling a little 3-ounce bottle of this fertilizer, 85 grams or so, and they're selling it for about $10. That works out to about $100 a liter of this solution for what probably has maybe 50 cents worth of bulk fertilizer in it. Now, if you think, no, there's something special in there, they've really formulated it for this growing system, well, I guess that's kind of what they want you to think. They want the people who buy the Aerogarden to think, oh, you can't use a different fertilizer. But I looked at the ingredients, I'll put them up on the screen now, and they're just run-of-the-mill, water-soluble bulk fertilizer that they've mixed and blended the same way they would mix their general Miracle-Gro. That is sort of this blue powder that you're accustomed to seeing in the store. And even if you cut out the middleman here and just bought the Miracle-Gro, you could cut your costs on this by a factor of, oh, you'd probably pay $2 for that same liter that you're otherwise paying $100 for if you buy it in that little size. Well, there probably is some good rule of thumb on YouTube that says you shouldn't break out the math unless you want to lose viewers for your video, but I promise this is the easiest sort of math because it's shopping math that everybody is familiar with. If you went to the grocery store and you said, I'm buying this box of Cheerios for this price, you could break it down into a cost per weight of Cheerios. Do the same thing on fertilizer, but what you have to do is you just have to say, the numbers on the front of the bag is what matters. The 16, 10, 10 on this bag talks about the percentage of this product that's nitrogen, potassium, and phosphorus, which are the active ingredients in most fertilizers. You can count the minor nutrients if they list those on the bag as well. But in total on this one here, I'm counting on there being 36 grams of fertilizer per 100 gram. That calculation is super easy in metric. So then if I also have a price per 100 grams, I can calculate how much fertilizer I'm getting for that price. That makes a lot of sense. I'll do that in the video here with some examples from Amazon, just so you can see what I'm saying about the classes of fertilizer is true, because the very worst deal in that group is the liquid type fertilizers. And now, of course, oftentimes they will say other things on the liquid fertilizer, like it's a compost tea, or it's made out of marine phytoplankton, or this one's got IBA in it, or humic acid, or other things like that. But in terms of the way it affects the growth of your plants, the thing you're really looking for is that guaranteed analysis. The NPK and the other nutrients is what fuels the growth of your plants. The other stuff we'll talk about in a minute, but this is the worst deal of all. The next one here is controlled release fertilizer. I'll just pull that out of the bag here and say that this is the coated fertilizer, and you may know it under brands like Osmocote or Multicoat. It's a coated fertilizer that releases over a length of time in your pots. I find that to be a convenient way to apply it. Absolutely. Very safe in your plants if you apply it in the right amounts. And that one there, of course, costs a little bit more because they put that coating on it, especially if you buy it in smaller amounts. And that's true of everything that you see here, is that generally if you buy it in a little tiny package, you pay a lot. If you buy it it in a big bulk package like this bag that I have here, you'll pay a little bit less, although this still tends to be on the pricey side. Next one up here in terms of cost is this fertilizer here. You're familiar with it. It's that sort of water-soluble powder fertilizer. That is generally just a little bit more expensive than the coated fertilizer, although that may depend on how you source them. They might be right on par with each other, but also on the expensive end as far as fertilizers go. Next one up is this kind of blended fertilizer that they usually have for use out in lawn and garden. And it's not a coated fertilizer, so it releases very, very quickly. If it rains, this gets released to the root zone. So it's an uncoated fertilizer, usually blended. And that one there is generally more inexpensive, but also a little more dangerous to apply out in the field because it releases so quickly. And then finally, the cheapest thing you're going to find is these simple fertilizers. This one here is calcium nitrate, magnesium sulfate, all of the simple chemical fertilizers by which they actually make the rest of these fertilizers out of them by blending these simples. Now, where do you get this stuff? Where do you get it in bulk? Well, honestly, you can do a lot of your shopping on the consumer end just by looking at Amazon or at your local feed store or horticulture store. Locally here, I buy all my stuff from TerraLink, and TerraLink is the horticulture distributor in the Lower Mainland, and there's other ones as well, but they don't require me to have any kind of a license to buy my stuff there. You just go to the office and you ask for the products and they give you the prices and so on. So with a little bit of, I guess, bravery, you can go and make these purchases yourself at your local feed or agriculture store if you're willing to buy it in the larger quantity. Let's talk about organic fertilizer and amendments here, because the exact same thing is true. If you bought your organic fertilizer all pre-blended and diluted and put into a little bottle as a liquid feed, it's going to cost you an awful lot per unit of fertilizer value. But if you bought it as a bulk amendment, like the farmers use, and got a bulk delivery of alfalfa or manure or compost, you'll end up getting far more bang for your buck. And I want to throw up a couple of labels of liquid organic fertilizers, because honestly, the amount of fertilizer that they're delivering is super, super low. On one of them, it totals to less than 0.5% of the entire product. And the other one really only has significant amounts of potassium in it from sulfate of potash, which if you bought it as a bulk amendment, you could buy a 50-pound bag of this stuff for like $40. That same calculation that I showed you with the conventional fertilizers is something you can apply directly over to the organic fertilizers. But what you actually need is a source of some data, because if you say, well, what is the NPK of cattle manure or alfalfa or other bulk amendments, you need to have a place to look for that. I have a link I'm going to put below the video where you can actually look up the different organic, common organic amendments or bulk amendments and see what their NPK is. Oftentimes when you're buying it in those blended liquid fertilizers, however, they've added in some other ingredients that are meant, I'm going to say, as distractions or the halo effect of organic fertilizer. Most of the value of organics, as opposed to conventional fertilizer, is in the value that it provides to the soil, to adding organic matter, to improving soil life, and so on. And that is more present in those bulk amendments. When you're buying it in a bottle, there's awfully little room there for that to improve your soil. So what they say is they're doing something like a compost tea, or they're adding liquid humic acid, or they're putting in marine phytoplankton or kelp with lots of micronutrients. And the thing is, if it can't be quantified as those guaranteed analysis, it might not actually be helping. And what they've done in the studies on, say, compost tea is they found that above and beyond the direct fertilizer value, the N, P, and K that it's delivering, compost tea doesn't consistently improve crops. And it's the same thing with humic acid that's sourced separately, or marine phytoplankton. There just isn't a lot of evidence out there that it does more than what the label is saying it should by the guaranteed analysis. So you can still count on those numbers. Really, when you're talking about the greater benefit of organic gardening or organic amendments, it's when you take something in bulk, like cattle manure, like alfalfa, you add it to your soil, and it helps to improve the structure and condition of the soil over time. You just can't get that in a bottle. All right, thanks for watching today. I hope that answered some of your questions about the value of fertilizer. And if you have any questions or comments about that, please drop those down below the video. I'll see what I can do to help.